You're not here for any of us, for me, for you, anyone that's around today. Today we're here to honor the men and women who made the ultimate sacrifice in service to our nation. Roscoe, if we were in the Quaker tradition, the Quakers would come in a service and they would remain silent for a while until someone had something to say worthwhile. And today, that would be absolutely appropriate if we just came here and gathered together and remembered and stayed silent. A good friend of mine wrote a poem that says it much better than I can when he said, "You are silent now, who once stood on battlefields ravaged by destruction unimaginable, holding in those desperate places the line of freedom for others you would never know and who would never know you. And being one of those you never knew, I would give all if I had to clasp your hand one single time, look into your eyes that witness the bloody carnage that results when freedom refuses to bow to chains of any kind and simply say thank you." So our being here today is simply a way of saying thank you to the nearly 1 million men and women who died fighting in wars since the American Revolution. These families remember their fallen loved ones every day, children without parents, Gold Star mothers and fathers, spouses and siblings. They can still hear the voices of those they had lost. But my friends, it's up to us to hear the voices of these families. It is up to us to offer them our support and express our highest gratitude. Whether the people we remember served, as we talked about, in World War II, a Navy veteran, God bless you, thank you for your service, sir. Whether it was Korea, Vietnam, the war on terrorism, or any place or any time in between, we say thank you to all those who gave us freedom. We are here because of you, our fallen comrades. Today, as I would ask you to have a moment of silence for all those who have gone, who made the ultimate sacrifice, I would ask you to remember our nation, to remember the men and women who are serving now in uniform in our nation. My grandson, Nicholas, is finishing up his training at Fort Benning in tanks. He's a Marine, and I'm very, very, very proud of him. When he told me, "Pop, I'm going into the Marine Corps," I said, "Come here, let me feel your head." But I am so proud of him, and I always will be. So he finishes his tank training at Fort Benning, Georgia, and he said, "Papa, I've got orders to an exotic place I've never heard before." I said, "Really?" He said, "Yeah, 29 Ponds, California." I said, "Nicholas, come here, let's talk a little bit." I said, "It's a great and beautiful place right near Joshua Tree National Forest. And you're not far from Palm Springs, and you can go down and see your aunt, my daughter, in San Diego. But just be careful what you're thinking in your mind about 29 Palms." And I'm sure all of us here have maybe grandchildren or children, nephews or nieces who are serving. And I would just ask you to really continue to pray for them and to pray for our nation as a result. These are fine young people. And I'm still convinced that America is the greatest land in the world, and it will continue to be if we continue to hold up the principles on which our nation was built and to honor those who have given us the freedoms that we have today. For 30 years, I had the opportunity to serve as a U.S. Navy chaplain. In those 30 years, I spent about half of that time with the Marine Corps, some with the Coast Guard, so I can stand up about for any anthem I want. But I am grateful that I had that opportunity, and I know as veterans here today that you also are grateful for the service that you rendered to our nation. And to the families at home, my wife who stayed home for those 30 years while I was at sea and in the field with the Marines. And so our families are a very, very important part of who we are as military people. So let's give our families a round of applause today. And in closing today, my 30 years as a chaplain is still ingrained in me, and my 2 years as National Chaplain for the Legion. And I'd just like to share a psalm with you in closing, and then I'll turn it back over. Psalm 100 says, "Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he who hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and his courts with praise. And be thankful unto him, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations." God bless you, God bless America, and God bless our fallen heroes. Thank you very much.